And we got two great lineups tonight. There's Tristan Jarry looking for a rebound season. He makes his first appearance of the preseason for Pittsburgh at the other end. It will be Anton Forsberg expected to play the full game for the Senators. We mentioned NHL-ready rosters for both teams, and that will include 18-year veteran Claude Giroux. His family made the six-hour drive from his hometown in Hearst, and it really has become a Northern Ontario celebration, and many more here, of course, to see Sid, the eternal kid, Sidney Crosby, at center ice for Pittsburgh. And Gary, a couple of really good lineups to get us in the regular season mood.
As it should be. I mean, when you put together something like this in the National Hockey League and the Players Association and Kraft, you want to bring all the big stars out. You want to celebrate it. These people have put a lot of time and effort into doing this, and you know what? Reward them with showing them the stars of the game. And it's great to see Sidney Crosby and out here with the Pittsburgh Penguins and Brady Tkachuk captaining this Ottawa Senators. Nice puck drop for those ladies from Elliott Lake, a big part of this.
Stutzla gets waved. It'll be Tkachuk against Crosby, the captain's duel, and Tkachuk wins the draw. Sanderson, Stutzla looking for Giroux in the corner. There's Stutzla playing it wide of the net, and Tkachuk on the other side, watched by Letang, the 19-year veteran on the Penguins' blue line. It'll be Giroux behind the net, kicks it back to Sanderson, the first shot, and that's stopped by Jarry. Now Nick Cousins checks in. Back to the line, Ottawa going right to the attack. Good shot, deflected wide. Travis Hamonic steps up, a big game for Hamonic in a battle for a job with the Senators, along with Jacob Bernard Docker, who's in the lineup as well tonight.
Well, that's one way to defend Sidney Crosby, is make him play defense. First shift for the Ottawa Senators. They've got the Penguins hemmed in.
Long lead feed, trying to spring Michael Bunting, the former Sioux Greyhound, who is back in a familiar rink. Raquel plays it in behind the net. There's Thomas Chabot up ahead. Cousins. Nick Cousins redlining in on a line with Amadio and Shane Pinto in this game. Out it goes, and Bunting unable to get that to Ricard Raquel. Centering pass, and Raquel there defensively looking to get his offensive game back on track after going 19 to start last year without a goal.
What a beautiful barn this is. 73 years old, this barn. It's incredible.
You'd never know it. And this might be as good a broadcast position as we could ever have, as we're hanging right above center ice. And not very far up. And an icing call against Pittsburgh.
You walk into the building, CC, and your senses just get alive. And these old buildings, you love these old barns filled with lots of hay. Good chance for the Senators. I mentioned they hemmed them in the first shift, and here's the shot from the point that comes through traffic from Sanderson. Jarry with a nice kick save. By his own admission, he needs to have a much better season this year. He's looking for more consistency in his game, and so are the Penguins if they're going to take a run at getting back into the playoffs.
Zach Ostapchuk wins the job for Ottawa, centering the fourth line for the Senators. He had a shorthanded game-winning goal earlier in the week against Toronto. There's Yannick, who had a goal and three assists in the first Ottawa preseason game against Toronto. It'll come back to Tyler Cleven. Tried to drop it, and it will come back out to center for Yannick. On a line with Ostapchuk, and they're both battling for perhaps one of the few jobs left to start the season. Up ahead it goes for Hayes, along with Cody Glass. And a former Ottawa draft choice, Jonathan Gruden, is out there on this line as well. Now Gruden peels back and hits to the bench on a change. And it's one of the things you noted right away, Gary, the benches are not on the same side, so it's an old school kind of night.
Well, there'll be a few adjustments in this game, not just the benches. The corners will come to the net a lot quicker. The lighting's a bit dimmer.
Stutzla in, there's Giroux trying to center, picked off by former Senator Boko Obama. And now played ahead at center. There's Sam Poulin, whose dad Patrick played in the league. A shot there by Stutzla. Jarry makes the save. Fed ahead, Obama looking for Poulin. That's cut off by Chabot. Up ahead for Tkachuk, bodied by Marcus Pettersson. And Tkachuk heads to the bench on a change. Here's Amama playing it across, and big Marcus Pettersson will steer it down the ice. Anthony Beauvillier out on the left flank along with Sidney Crosby and Brian Rust, who has been a mainstay with Crosby over the last 5 years. Out at center ice, it's picked off here by Cousins. Here's Nick Cousins working in front, and Jari the stop. Chabot moved up, but he hit that out of midair about waist high, and Jari looked sharp on that. Loose puck in front again, scores! Nick Cousins breaks the ice in Kraft Hockeyville.
Well, one of the new guys the Senators have brought aboard, a Stanley Cup champion with the Florida Panthers last year. And he gets a great opportunity coming to the net as he fakes the shot on Brunick, cuts right across. Jari makes the save, then the rebound from Chabot. There's a little collision. Jari gets pushed out of the net. He finds his way back in, and before he can get himself settled, Cousins has circled back around and come into the top of the circle, and he lets this rip, and he finds the back of the net. The Ottawa Senators, 4 minutes into this game, and have been the best team thus far, get the first goal by Nick Cousins.
Well, a native of Belleville, a Stanley Cup winner, as you mentioned, 592 games in the NHL. Cousins will add some grit and experience to this lineup. Here comes Bunting the other way, and Forsberg made the stop on a 2-on-1 for Ottawa. Ridley Gregg lost the puck to his numerical counterpart, Evgeny Malkin.
Bring some edginess. That's what Cousins brings. The energy, but edginess. You want that little bit of sandpaper.
Steve Steos, who will guest with Ron McLean later in the broadcast, looking for role players. Cousins certainly fits that role, and Steve Steos will be with Ron in the second intermission. There's a jolt on Cody Glass. Like, that stung him a bit. Glass is going to make his way to the bench. Working in with Stutzler, lost the puck, and Glass still feeling the effects of that bump along the boards.
Well, Pittsburgh bounces back on right the next shift in a long stretch pass, and all of a sudden, here comes Bunting down the right side. He has Malkin, but good job by Hamonic protecting the pass across, so he has to take the shot. Nice save there by Forsberg, and there's the collision by Klavan with Glass, and you could tell right away, as soon as they ran into each other, when Glass kind of came off the hit, that something wasn't right, and good to get off and have the trainers have a look at it. Well, we all know how important the start is going to be for the Ottawa Senators this year. I mean, there's no doubt about it. You can talk all you want.
Here's a centering pass, Patterson in front, and unable to get the shot to the net was Drake. Drake Patterson caused the turnover on the goal by Cousins, and usually plays a starring role in the Senators' Hockeyville games. Patterson in on the attack, looking for his own rebound. Centers it in front, and that shot played wide of the net. Here's Chabot, quickly into the skates of David Perron. Back to Chabot, shot, rebound. Drake battles for it, and Jari down to hold it out. Senators come close again.
A real nice start for the Ottawa Senators. A lot of transition, a lot of attack. They're jumping on the pucks quickly. Perron out in front, and a nice slick pass over to Gregg from Batherson. Doesn't work out, but they still stay on top of the puck. And there you see Chabot getting pucks to the net. Batherson tries to go through the legs to Gregg. And I mentioned the dimness of the building, the lighting a little bit dimmer. Perron, who normally wears a kind of like sunglass visor, has cleared his visor so he can see better in the game.
Here's the goal scorer, Cousins. Patterson given the lone assist. Rust ahead, tried to get to Beauvillier, and Cousins knocked that down. Back the other way is Shane Pinto over the line. Ron showed you the picture of Pinto as a youngster. He idolized Sidney Crosby. He trained with him this summer, and mentioned earlier today, he understands how Sidney Crosby can play 20 years in the league, the way he works and how dedicated he is in the offseason to honing his craft. Sent in by Amadio, and Pettersson back to get it. Penguins' third preseason game, have lost two to Buffalo. Senators coming off a loss to the Sabres, and Travis Green didn't like the performance and was hoping to see a response here tonight. Amama plays it in, and there's Glass back, so that's good news for the Penguins. Owen Pickering, a young defenseman, vying for a job. Number 38 out of Kamloops is on the ice. Excuse me, Swift Current. They've got a Kamloops defenseman. Harrison Brunick will be in the Pittsburgh lineup as well. There's Poulin to the red line, drops it in along with Bunting. Steered by Forsberg to Bernard Docker. Up for Tkachuk at center, broken up by Raquel, but here's Giroux. Claude Giroux played some minor hockey in this building. And cut down at center was Bunting, first penalty. Oh no, the arm went up, but play continues. Here's Malkin. Tried to center it, but bounces to Tkachuk. On the move is Stützle. Matt Grzelcyk watches him. Back it goes. Jensen across. Stützle gets it back and fires high. Gruden with an outlet. Raquel couldn't take that pass. Now back ahead to the veteran Raquel at center, and he heads off on a change. Here's one of the new veterans on the Senators, Nick Jensen, who will be in the top four for Ottawa. Round behind the net, and Jensen activates up against Gruden, whose dad briefly was a Senator in the late 90s. There's a hit on Brunick, the Kamloops defenseman, who was a first-round draft choice of Pittsburgh. Shabbat at the line, gets it to Perron, fires, and that goes off Brunick wide. Sent back in deep, and it finds Perron looking to center it. Batherson couldn't corral that, and Glass out through center. Cody Glass got married in early August. Within 2 weeks, he was traded from Nashville to Pittsburgh. As the Penguins look to get a little younger. Pass for Pinto too far. Beauvillier turns. Back with Rust. Here's Beauvillier to the middle. Chris Letang in front. Crosby scores! Sidney Crosby here has tied it in Kraft Hockeyville. And Gary, a lot of fans came to see just that.
Well, Sidney Crosby, such a great ambassador of the game of hockey in the National Hockey League, and he does everything so well, driving to the net here. Good transition. Beauvillier takes the puck off the wall, and then Rust goes to the net, which opens up the drop pass to Letang. And as we've seen so many times, these guys have played for so long together. They know where each other is on the ice. Letang with the backhand pass right through the seam, and Sidney Crosby just opens up his blade and deflects it right into the wide open net. And nice pass from Letang, but just really good, solid transition by the Penguins.
Well, he scored 42 times last year, tied for 11th in the league in scoring. Third time in his career he's hit the 40-goal mark. Eight times a 90-point man. He's done that in the last 2 years, so there's been no drop-off. He just keeps on keeping on.
And when they needed a guy to step up,
steal by Malkin, and Forsberg had to be sharp on that.
You know, in April, when those last games were coming up and they were fighting to get in the playoffs, he put up like 25 points
in the last 13 games.
13 games, I mean, he put them on his back.
Malkin bumping with Yannick in front of the Ottawa bench. On a hit that Malkin took exception to at the echo of the whistle. Well, a good start. Nick Cousins breaks the ice for Ottawa, but 87 gets it back for the Penguins.
Won the Stanley Cup this past season, so it was his turn to have the Stanley Cup. It was in Belleville on August 20th, and of course the smiles and the opportunity to share it with people in his home community. And the family was there. One of the great shots is, look at the golf course here. Everybody's smiling, but a guy is still working on his backswing there. Can never give up on your golf game, guys.
I'm working on it, Baldy. I'm working on it.
Well, what a great, solid year for Cousins. And when it ends with a Stanley Cup and you get to celebrate with your family and friends and your community like that, that is something special.
Senators called for too many men. We'll see the Pittsburgh power play. Malkin unable to get the E shot away there, and it's cleared down the ice. Both teams in situations they want to improve vastly. Penguins 30th, unbelievably, on the power play last year, and the Senators 29th on the penalty kill.
It's kind of mind-boggling when you have this kind of talent on one power play.
Along with Erik Karlsson last year, Malkin shot absorbed by Forsberg. By the way, Karlsson not only not here, but has not skated with the Penguins yet, although Mike Sullivan is saying that he still should be ready for opening night, but a lot of people are wondering if that will be the case.
Well, Malkin steps right in the middle of the ice. He's right down Main Street, and he puts him right in the crest.
There's a shot from distance, loose puck, and Malkin couldn't reach that to the blue paint. Out comes Jensen, a hit to Giroux. He'll turn back. Might have had a two-on-one developing, but will kill some time, and now Shabbat wires it into the zone. That took a funny bounce and fell into the Pittsburgh zone for an Ottawa recovery.
They hit the stanchion right by the penalty box and just took a dead left along the blue line. I think the linesman thought, did that not hit somebody? He had his whistle going up, but he let it go.
He felt like calling it. It's hard to track. And by the way, Shander Afonso, who gets the assignment, he is a former Sudbury Wolf. A chance in front, and Beauvillier deflects that high and out.
Well, the Pittsburgh Penguins with a couple of good chances. Beauvillier gets this one here. Nice pass up the middle of the ice. Backs off to Sens D, and then here's the attack. And they're getting to the net. Crosby walked in and tipped that one in, and there's another one. Beauvillier driving to the net. But, yeah, I mean, they're going to make some changes, obviously, bringing in Coach Quinn, who coached in San Jose and the Rangers. He's going to look after the power play for the Penguins this year, and they're going to make some tweaks on it for sure.
Loose puck at the side of the net. Cousins defending. Here's big Kevin Hayes. Pass back to the line for Grzelcyk, the former Bruin. 9 seconds of the power play. Glass puts it on. Rebound collected, but not cleared. Held at the line by Grzelcyk. In deep, looking for Beauvillier. And Hayes. Bunting holds the zone, flips it in front. Glove down there by Jensen. Senators don't clear. It's Bunting again. Firing. Glove stop. Forsberg. And a beauty. So the Senators kill the first power play of the game, and with an exclamation mark, Forsberg turns Pittsburgh away.
It's a score sheet from that game, and there is a Sudbury connection. Bottom right corner, you see the autograph, Randy Pascal. Well, Randy Pascal and Todd Guthrie, Randy on the left, Todd right next to them, were in the score area for that game. They were the scorer and timekeeper for that golden goal. And it is still a reminder. In fact, Randy's wearing his vest from 2010. So, Chris, I think you remember that goal a little bit, don't you?
I do recall that goal. What an afternoon in Vancouver that was. Pulling on the draw against Ostapchuk. Runick sends it into the corner, knocked down by Klevin. Unique trying to clear it, played right back in by Pittsburgh. The fourth line's out for both teams. Unique redirecting that. Ostapchuk in the middle, and now Zach MacEwen in front. And Ostapchuk unable to catch up to that. Now comes up with it. Back to the line for Klevin, a shot, and that goes wide. Here's Bernard Docker stepping up. The two North Dakota defensemen in the same pairing here, Bernard Docker and Klevin. Of course, there's three of them with Jake Sanderson in the lineup as well. Up ahead, off the stick of Tkachuk. Letang with a shoulder check. Got Stützle on the forecheck and flips it back out to center ice. There's Sanderson, right side to Tkachuk. And now Giroux on it. Here's Giroux. Hurst. 550 kilometers west of here. Stützle scores! Tim Stützle, stick side on Jarry, and Ottawa regains the lead.
Well, this is what makes Tim Stützle so electric. I mean, he's got such a great set of skill sets, but he keeps his feet moving all the time. And if you're a youngster watching this game, you can learn from that, that you never stop your feet from moving. Nice job by the veteran, Giroux. He settles the puck down, gets it to Stützle. He moves it to the point, keeps rolling along the top. When he picks it up, those feet keep moving and moving until he separates from the Penguins. Once he gets the space he needs, then it's a matter of just picking his head up and picking a spot in the net, and he didn't miss it. Short side on Jerry. Big goal, 7:05 to go here in the first, and the Senators take another one-goal lead.
Had a goal, 3 assists against Pittsburgh last year. He had a good start to the season last year, 33 points in his first 30 games, but just 70 on the season after 90 the year before. Malkin testing for it for rebound. That was blocked in front. Again, Pittsburgh with a response shift after the goal. Now up ahead it goes, and here come the Senators to the attack. Batherson couldn't sift that pass through. Pittsburgh rolls it down. Jensen striding back. Not enough for Isaac. David Perron. Chabot works his way in deep. Just plays it in behind the net. Here's Harrison Brunick. Born in Johannesburg, South Africa. Second NHL draft choice ever from South Africa, following Ole Kolzik.
Winners of $250,000 to upgrade their arena and tonight's NHL preseason game. We celebrate Elliott Lake, Ontario, proud winner of Kraft Hockeyville 2024.
Good first period, just over 6 minutes remaining. 2-1 Ottawa as it's tipped in by Michael Amadio, former captain of North Bay. He scored his 50th OHL goal in this building. Clevin moves up, looking to center. That pass denied. Clevin works it loose. Cycled back by Cousins. There's Bernard Docker. Amadio behind the net. Swings away from Pettersson, tried to center it. Back to Clevin. Drops it in deep, and Amadio on it again. Clevin across. Off the bench comes Unique and shoots, and that'll stick to Jari with some jostling in front of the Pittsburgh net. So Tim Stützle restores the Senator lead here in the first. Ottawa with the lead.
Cousins buries this one right here, fires that into the top of the net. That started the game off 1-0, but shortly after that, it was a Letang pass, a nice backhand beauty to Crosby, who kind of takes it out of the air, knocks that into the net. We were tied at one until just a few minutes ago. A nice little bunt pass from Hamonic to Stützle, cuts through the high slot, picks his head up and buries it. Those are the 3 goals in the first period, and Senators with a 1-goal lead with 5:30 to go.
Face off in the Pittsburgh zone, won by Crosby. Sidney Crosby, 45 points from passing Joe Sakic to move into 9th in all-time scoring. The one that interests me, Gary, he's 212 points shy of Gordie Howe to register the most points in NHL history for one franchise. That would be quite a milestone. He has just signed a new 2-year extension. Probably would need a 3rd year to beat Mr. Hockey's record.
Well, one thing about Sidney is you never count him out, you never know. You just never know, and well deserved too. I mean, to spend the time that he has in Pittsburgh and what he's accomplished in Pittsburgh, not just on the ice, but off the ice, and for the game of hockey, it would be really nice to see.
And also the bargain and signature salary of $8.7 million a year. Here's Chabot. Puck loose, flipped away, and McEwen gets Ottawa pointed in the right direction. Unique across, bouncing puck at the line, and the play is offside.
I had the pleasure of growing up with Steve Yzerman and playing against him at a young age, minor hockey and early in Tier 2 junior hockey. He was something special. 19 years he was the captain of the Detroit Red Wings. That is the longest in NHL history. And Sidney Crosby, this will be his 18th season for the Pittsburgh Penguins, wearing the C on his sweater. And there is no doubt that he will eventually pass Steve Yzerman as well. And what a tremendous job he has done as a captain. Leads by example. When your captain steps on the ice, whether it be a game or practice or whatever, and does what Sidney Crosby does, everyone else has to follow.
will be a milestone year if he stays healthy. 592 goals, 1,596 points for Crosby. Malkin also sitting on some milestones. He's at 498 goals, so 500 should come early as Jari holds on. It's the semifinals of the WNBA playoff. Catch game one between the Connecticut Sun and Minnesota Lynx tonight, 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific on Sportsnet 360.
Well, one thing that's going to make Travis Green happy, we showed the goals in the first period, the two Ottawa Senator goals, you know, they get it on pucks. Batherson dusts up the first one. Drew gets in on the second one. Getting in on the forecheck, winning battles for pucks, creating offense off of those. It's got them two goals here in the first period.
Stützle against Glass on this draw after Hayes was waved out. Fired around by Pettersson. A battle by Bernard Docker to kick it back in deep. Clevin on the near side. Hayes trying to wrap him up. It's Giroux for Tkachuk. Challenging the young defenseman. Brunick, who chases him back. Now Pettersson. Pass intercepted there by Tkachuk. Brady Tkachuk playing it right on. We'll have an official shot clock operating here tonight. Tkachuk with a point off the post. Bernard Docker from long range hits iron. Glass slowing things down. 3 minutes left in the period. Crosby checks back in with Beauvillier and Rust. Here's a lead feed too far for Beauvillier. Shane Pinto tied up along the boards with Rust. Crosby trying to dig it loose. Now Jensen against Beauvillier. And it does come loose onto the stick to Pinto, who starts back. Pinto's been centering the second line in the preseason, but on a different unit here tonight, along with Amadio. Nice move by Letang. Crosby in the corner. McCousins up against Crosby, who didn't like that. Pinto away at center. Red line and in, he'll drop it in and head to the bench on a change. Owen Pickering, the former Swift Current Bronco, ahead. That's off the skate to Vamama, stays in the zone. Pickering flicking it back out. And Sanderson charges back, but Forsberg out to play it away from the front of the net. Sanderson bumped off Gruden and stays on the puck. Here come the Senators, that shot. Off Jari. Loco Amama will flip it to the line and back out at center. Senators regroup. That pass intercepted by Bunting. Lost it. Unique there, and Bunting able to recover. Now charging in is a stop check. He's up in it in the corner. Now sent back to the line for Clevin. Across it goes to Bernard Docker. Senators on the change here. Batherson's up. Drake Batherson looking for a loose puck, and Amama there to play it off the boards and back down into Ottawa ice. Final minute, opening period. Batherson at center. Jari out to play that. Jari struggled down the stretch. In fact, it was Alex Nedeljkovic that played the last 13 games of the Penguins' regular season in their push for the playoffs that came up 3 points short of Washington. Pettersson and now Malkin. Back to Marcus Pettersson, and Malkin will start back, the eldest player on the Penguins at 38 years of age. And the clock draining, and that's going to do it for the first period, and a entertaining opening period as the horn sounds. Senators with the lead, and they came close to expanding it on a point shot by Jacob Bernard Docker.
Yeah, just glanced it off the right post there. It just came through some traffic here. Jarry doesn't pick it up till late. And I don't know if it went off something or deflected
or not.
I think
Brady Tkachuk got a stick on that, So Nick Cousins opened the scoring from Batherson. Crosby answered. And then Stützle at 12:55, 4 minutes after the tying goal by the Penguins. Restores Ottawa's lead. Travis Hamonic and Claude Giroux assisting.
Man wearing number 96 is David Brisebois, linesman from Sudbury, and he has done 1,500 games in the NHL, but this is the first time he's been in Sudbury since he officiated in the OHL. He's the only linesman from Sudbury in the NHL officiating corps, and he's delighted to be back on home ice.
That's awesome. David, one of the great veterans wearing stripes in the National Hockey League. Shots were 59 in favor of Ottawa in the opening period. Stützle, Batherson, Cousins, Chabot, and Sanderson all with two shots in the period. Bunting and Malkin with three apiece.
And the tempo was just really good for Ottawa. I really liked their start, and it kind of carried them through the period.
Crosby on this faceoff in the Ottawa zone. Letang, little touch and redirected by Rust, and Forsberg will freeze that.
Carlson's not in the lineup, but he does a very similar thing that Letang does. You know, he sets up for the shot, but he's always looking who is off to the side of the net, who's in the high slot. He's already hit Crosby at the side of the net there. That was a little push to Rust in the middle of the ice, and he just redirects it and just really heads up defenseman, and a guy who plays a ton of minutes for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
There's a face-off, one rush shot doesn't get through, and the Senators will bounce it out. Letang with an assist on the Crosby goal, 57 points last year for Chris Letang. Crosby nearly had a loose puck in front of the net. Letang, Rust, and a shot by Grizzlick. Knocked down in front, and away goes Sanderson. Here's Sanderson to the left side. Cousins trying to return the pass. And now Beauvillier turns. Chops that to center. Knocked down by Amadio. Played deep by Rust. And Forsberg will hand that off to Yannick. Here comes the smooth skating Nick Jensen. Red line and in for Ottawa. Pinto on the near side. Gets a jolt there from Pettersson. Batherson looking to center. Moving up is Jensen. Slowed up by Raquel, but puck in deep for Batherson in front, and Pinto couldn't get there ahead of Raquel. Kept alive by Perron. Batherson sweeps it around. Ottawa changing. Some of the bodies were out there, and now a penalty coming up against Pittsburgh. Here's Chabot dropping it off. Bernard Docker, extra attacker, comes on as Forsberg gets to the bench. Ridley Gregg plays it rink wide. Stützle and Batherson kicking it back to Chabot. Nice move by Chabot, then checked, and the penalty about to be called as Bunting touches the puck. And it will be Michael Bunting heading off.
You'll see the stick right there get caught in the midsection of Ridley Gregg, and he goes down, and there's your penalty call right there. But good job by Gregg. When that puck got dumped around the wall, there were way too many Senators on the ice, and instead of skating up to grab the puck, he waited, he backed up in a good defensive posture, waited for the puck to come around, let his guys get off the ice, and then he ends up drawing the penalty as Mike Sullivan will set up his penalty killing unit. Besides coaching the Penguins this year, he'll also be coaching Team USA in the Four Nations Cup.
Tkachuk wins the draw. Senators on their first power play of the night. Amadio looks to center. That blocked in front by Pickering. Tkachuk back to the line. Sanderson to the middle. Down low it goes. A pass for Tkachuk broken up. And Pittsburgh clears. Penguins tied for 10th on the kill last year. The Senators 23rd on the power play. And that's a ranking that should go up this year. The Senators are going to have more success. Stützle around, Amadio. On the near side, dropping it off. Batherson trying to work his way from Poulin. Sanderson, Batherson looking for Stützle. Jake Sanderson midpoint. Here's Stützle in a good spot, shooting it. Jari turns that aside. Batherson. Poulin loses his footing. Tkachuk from the corner. Centering pass off Pettersson. Poulin in a battle. Good strong stick by Batherson to keep it alive. Sanderson moving up. In low, Tkachuk, and he had a glance off his stick right to Jari.
I think Sanderson should have went right to Stützle on the far side, then through to Tkachuk. I think he wish he would have done it now, but good movement by the Ottawa Senators. Good power plays, move the puck quickly, and they move the their bodies quickly. They change positions, they interact with one another. You can't stay stagnant and hang around. There's the pass down to Tkachuk, but Jari was already there. He didn't really have much to do with it. When he stepped out to the middle, right across to Stützle, I think would have been the better play.
Beaudreau on the draw, Shabbat. Sends it across. There's David Perron working his way in. Back to Giroux. Up top, Shabbat. His shot deflected. Pinto got a piece of that. Jari loses his stick but made a big save on the redirect by Pinto. 20 seconds left of the power play. Senators came close. Perron, and now Pinto stopped again by Jari. Now Giroux throws it in front. Jari looking for it. Can't freeze it, still loose. And now play called, and Jari's still without his stick.
I think Renouf almost put that right into his own net. Good job by Jari. He made a couple of real good combination saves here. Again, the power play for Ottawa. Moving bodies, moving the puck quickly, shots to the net, good depth screening, Pinto with the deflection, and bodies at the net. Look at Perron, that's where he hangs out. He digs out these pucks. He's an edgy guy who'll get in there and dig out pucks. And nice job by Jari without his stick to make a couple of good saves. And there's the one. Renouf knocks it back with his back right skate, and Jari comes across with his right pad. It's kind of really odd. Some goalies, when they lose their goalie stick, they want someone to give them a stick, and some of them don't. They'd rather play without it. And Jari without a stick making a number of good saves there for the Penguins.
Had 34 wins in the 21-22 season. Spectacular year, but last year a career worst 903 save percentage. That one deflected just wide. Ridley Gregg battling for the puck. Perron centers it. Good stick by Jari as Batherson was tied up in front. Penalty done. Four shots on goal for the Senator power play, but unable to expand the lead. Now Bunting out of the box to the attack. Stopped up inside the line by Hamonic. Gregg back with Batherson. That shot knocked down by Jari, and back to the attack. Bunting with Rust. They're checked inside the line. Letang back to get it. Here's Letang up ahead. Late for Crosby, but let's see. The call at the line is offside.
Winners of $250,000 to upgrade their arena and tonight's NHL preseason game. We celebrate Elliott Lake, Ontario. Proud winner of Kraft Hockey Bill 2024.
Well, for both these teams, not making the playoffs is just not good enough for them. And both teams have talked quite a bit about how they're going to try to get themselves back into a playoff situation this year. And I think going a long way for both teams would be their power play improving for sure.
Last time the Senators made the playoffs, they went to the conference final, losing in game seven to the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Well, the starts have really buried them. They just have not had good starts. I think they need to get good goaltending. And the one thing in Buffalo the other night that was good was their goaltending. Yeah. Ullmark looked fantastic. And if you're Steve Staios, you got to be thrilled about that.
Well, that sends a message to the whole team too, doesn't it?
Well, you can hide imperfections if your goaltending is really good, but you can't lean on it all the time. They've got to be a better, more structured, so much better in their end. In the defensive zone, they've got to be better structured and just more disciplined. You can't have the critical turnovers that they had in a lot of occasions last year. They've got to be better in that zone. And Travis Green will help them there. He's going to be a real stickler for how they play in their zone.
And McEwen bumped along the boards by Brunick. Fired back around to the near side. Bernard Docker, rink wide. Clevin shooting that. It gets through on to Jari. Anthony Beauvillier backhands it away. And inside the Ottawa line, a lead feed from Bernard Docker. Doesn't reach an Ottawa stick. Up ahead it goes. Bunting redirects that inside the line. Sanderson quickly ahead. It's Tkachuk. Stutzla with Giroux. Couldn't get him the pass. But a shot by Hamonic right on. Nice right pad stop by Jari. Bunting the other way. Missed the pass. And Stutzla back there defensively. Here comes Giroux through center. Got Tkachuk on the left side with Stutzla. And Hamonic fired that. And it deflects off Hayes. And out of play. And now Hamonic and Renouf and Tkachuk. Renouf has dropped the gloves. That might not be a good idea against Brady Tkachuk.
Well, he is some kind of angry, and Brady's kind of messing with him here, but he is some kind of angry. And for Brady Tkachuk, you don't need to be fighting in preseason games.
Penalties upcoming, 6:19 into the second. Kraft Hockeyville. Couple of NHLers from Elliott Lake, Alex Henry and Zach Stortini. Both were drafted by the Oilers. Both have some Elliott Lake toughness. Stortini also was a mainstay of the Sudbury Wolves, and for 3 years he was a teammate of Shandor Alfonso, linesman here tonight, who has the honor of working the lines with David Brisebois. So Sudbury connections for both linesmen in this game.
It's a big game, but it's a small world, and six degrees of separation, and so many people are connected.
No coincidental minors on that last dust-up between Tkachuk and Renouf. 4-on-4 with Rust and Crosby to work. Jumping up here is Matt Grzelcyk, the former Bruin, signed as a free agent. And he'll be paired with Letang this season. Rust has got it. Back to Letang. There is Grzelcyk. Up high is Rust. Dropping it off for Letang. Watched by Greg. And Letang threw it in front. Good stick there by Shabbat. And trying to send away Ridley Gregg. Batherson follows, finds some space, fires, and Jari able to knock that down. It was nice work, a delay by Batherson to make himself available for a good shot on Tristan Jari. Now Raquel spun around. Continues on. Now plays it back to Brunick and Pettersson. Here comes Harrison Brunick out of the Calgary Minor Hockey Association. Worked out a lot in the offseason with Carter Yakimchuk, who made such a terrific impression in the first preseason game against Toronto, scored the highlight reel end-to-end overtime goal. By the way, it's Yakimchuk's 19th birthday today. And his training partner on the other side for the Penguins as Yakimchuk gets the night off, but still very much in the Ottawa picture here. Brunick back and now hands it off to the veteran Kevin Hayes. Beauvillier's on the move. Here's Beauvillier trying to charge through against Shabbat. Jensen an outlet to Mario in the middle, and Nick Cousins, who opened the scoring, goes to work with Tkachuk out of the penalty box. Mario hit along the boards by Hayes. Renouf back in the fray, an outlet pass there by Grzelcyk, and it's lofted to center as Tkachuk lined up Grzelcyk. Here's Hayes over the line. Hayes at the end of a shift hits off. Up ahead, it's Tkachuk cruising on the left wing. Here's Tkachuk holding, looking for Bernard Docker that got away from him. Stutzla spun around. Giroux, that goes off the leg of Poulin, and Giroux will get it back inside his line. He gets tripped, and another penalty upcoming against Pittsburgh. As Letang touches it, we'll see the Senator power play once again. We've got more NHL preseason action for you tomorrow. Canucks head to Edmonton to take on the Oilers. Our coverage begins at 9 Eastern, 7 Mountain, 6 Pacific on Sportsnet.
Poulin in the box for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and once again the stick gets into the legs right there of Claude Giroux, and he went down quickly, and the Ottawa Senators go back on the power play, and their power play has looked pretty good tonight. It's had really good movement. The puck has moved quickly. They seem to have found guys in good spots to get scoring chances, and Mike Sullivan not happy with the call and not happy with the penalties, the last couple of penalties. You read lips, he's saying that's an awful call.
Trying to read lips there earlier because Giroux was giving Renouf an earful after his little altercation with Tkachuk. He's gone to the bench, surprised that he went off as his power play starts with Perron, Greg, Pinto, Giroux, and Chabot in the middle. Pinto couldn't get it through. Pinto a couple looks on the last power play. That one blockered down. And a broken stick as Pinto shot snapped the twig of Cody Glass, who picks up a new stick and goes to the end looking for a shorthanded goal. Stopped by Forsberg. Pettersson plays it back in deep. Glass took the handoff at the bench and nearly ended up converting for a shorthanded equalizer. Here's Greg back. Perron, great pass in front. Oh, it went off the post. Greg unable to cash an empty net. I don't think that Jari got a stick on that, did he?
I think he hit the post.
Yeah.
That was a wide open cage and just nothing but net to look at.
Stutz Labak. Amadio leaned on by Beauvillier. Batherson moves up. In the middle it goes. Sanderson shoots wide from a good scoring spot. Sanderson again, and he bobbled that, has to regroup at center. Just under 40 seconds remaining in this second Ottawa power play. They've had their chances. Here's Stützle. Tkachuk. Sanderson plays catch and now has Amadio moving up. Hands it off. Stützle. His goal the difference right now. Batherson, Tkachuk, Amadio parks in front. Here's Stützle, Amadio in the slot, shot blocked by Grzelcyk. And the puck cleared out to center by Gruden. Two shots on the power play. And back at full strength, the Penguins. Hayes over the line with Poulin. Crosby comes over the boards. Now Stützle, trying to get away from the dogged checking of Crosby. Nearly lost it. Got it to the line. Brought back in. That's offside Pittsburgh.
Well, an interesting shift for the Penguins on the penalty kill. Right here, you're going to see the broken stick. Cody Glass. This puck comes through. Jari makes the save. And then got to give the trainers a lot of credit. They get the sticks to their guys so quickly. Renouf back to Glass with a brand new twig. He tries to go five hole. Forsberg says, no way. And then a wide open net right there for Ridly Gregg, and he gets nothing but the iron.
Rink, or the rebuilt rink in Elliott Lake. And 160 Ks away. Sudbury Community Arena, Pittsburgh and Ottawa. And Philip Larson is in for the second half of the game. Got a brief warm-up, which doesn't usually happen, but will happen this year. A new rule, Gary, if there's concussion protocol that takes a goaltender out of the game, the backup will be allowed to be warmed up.
They're spoiling the goalies now.
There's Amadio working it in front, and Hamonic unable to catch that.
That's the third time Hamonic has gotten into the A spot, the A scoring spot up the ice. Good on him.
Crosby, Beauvillier, and Forsberg holds on to that.
We talk Sanderson, we talk Chabot and the goal, Kemchuk's goal the other night in overtime, but Travis Hamonic, I mean, and he is fighting for a spot as well. He's a veteran guy who wants to say, hey, I can still get this done, and he has jumped up the ice on a couple of occasions. The timing has been really good. He's got himself some pretty good scoring opportunities. And it's a defense core that the Senators management are going to take a hard look at before they choose their six or seven guys they're going to move into the season with. There are some options there for them.
Still haven't seen Artem Zub, who has been nicked in training camp. That's an icing call against
Zub's obviously going to be in their top four guys. But, you know, a guy like Klevin, here's a guy that is a big, tall, rangy guy, who's a stay-at-home guy, might be a nice piece to fit with Shabbat or Sanderson, to play with them, to give them a little more space and give that pairing a little bit of more defensive conscience. But, you know, and then you got Bernard Docker. Can he hang on? Can he stay in the lineup full-time for the Ottawa Senators? And then you talk about Yakimchuk, this combo of size and skill. Is he ready to take the step?
He is still very much in the mix and not automatic to be sent back to his junior team anytime soon. Back out at center. Malkin will turn back in his own zone. Just six power play goals for Evgeny Malkin last year. 27 goals on the year for Malkin. Bunting on the forecheck, and Ostapchuk is back for Ottawa. Lost the handle on it, and there is Glass. Turning it ahead to Amamo over the line, and he'll send it deep. Hayes to the line, Letang. Back to Hayes in the slot, and moving up on the play was Pickering, couldn't reach that long pass. Ostapchuk the other way. Sends it deep, Yannick after it against Hayes. Letang with the outlet to the young defenseman, Owen Pickering. After it is Glass, but Ridley Gregg comes away with the puck, and now it's Bernard Docker. 104 games for Bernard Docker in the NHL in the last 4 years, and looking for his first full season. Crosby gloves it down and goes to work. Here's Crosby over the line, rolled it through, and Beauvillier didn't see it coming. Crosby trying to dig it out of the pile. Now Batherson gets it back from Bernard Docker. Here's Drake Batherson, rink wide. Drake trying to knock down that high pass. Batherson across, got it back. Gregg swinging a miss as he fanned on a shot from a pretty good spot in front. Now Batherson, but a penalty coming up as Grizzlick was knocked down and an interference call being assessed against the Senators.
This might be on Batherson as he comes out of the corner, and just good hard play. I'm not sure if it is or not. No, it's going to be Ridley Gregg. The two of them were battling here. There's where Batherson bangs into him, and as Gridley, the guilty party in the box, Ridley Gregg, and it didn't take much for this call. I kind of think if I'm going to put it in a column, I'd put it in the soft column. Right there, that little push on Grizzlick, and Batherson, to me, has already bumped him and turned and gone, and Grizzlick's balance looked a bit off and didn't like the call, but nonetheless, the Penguins will head back on the power play, and a power play that certainly, as we've already discussed, CCA, it's got to improve as this training camp goes along. They got to go into the season with a bit of confidence.
So the second power play of the game there, 2 for 7 in the preseason. That shot wired wide, kept alive by Crosby. Good play along the boards to make sure that didn't leave the zone. He'll set it up high. Malkin back to Letang and returns to 71. Crosby down low. There's Raquel. Tied up along the boards. Russ gets it free. Malkin. Off the stick, scores! Well, that's a strange one. A strange deflection fools Forsberg, and the game is tied.
Another helper for Letang, but the one thing that they did on this power play, they didn't do in the last one, was to interchange the pieces. Crosby was up top, he interchanged with Letang a couple of times, and Malkin interchanged as well, and Russ digs out this puck, and Letang puts this in the wrong spot. He wanted to lay that into Malkin for the one-timer, but he gets it on his backhand, which kind of makes him have to wait and turn it when he throws it. It goes off the stick of Jake Sanderson, up into the air, pop fly, comes down over the top of Forsberg. I think Crosby picked it up a bit late. You see him watching over his head, and it finds the back of the net. And not a pretty goal, but a power play goal for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and they tie it up with 4:55 to go here in the second period.
Mentioned Malkin, 498 career goals. I don't think he's scored many quite like that. But the game tied at two. Crosby and Malkin have scored for Pittsburgh. Probably not the first time that's happened.
From Letang.
From Letang, yeah. A couple of 37-year-olds and a 38-year-old still leading the way in Pittsburgh.
Look at the Senators relying on Claude Giroux over the last few years, and now bringing in Perron, another 36-year-old. You know, you can't get enough of that veteran leadership.
Shabbat, response shift for Ottawa here, and upended was Ostapchuk in front. Play continues. A move there along the boards by McEwen to Ostapchuk, pinned by Pettersson. Yannick tries to work it loose. McEwen's pass picked off. And Boko Obama, who played most of last year with the Belleville Senators, sends it down into Ottawa territory. Unique turning back, reversing it for Jensen. Up ahead at center. Unable to corral that was McEwen. Now Jensen looks for McEwen. Knocked down by Renouf. Back comes Raquel and Malkin. Evgeny Malkin to the line. Dan Renouf shots it. Looked like it went off Unique and wide. At the line, Pickering shot, blocked by McEwen. Raquel in the corner. Here's Owen Pickering stepping up again. The swift current Bronco plays it back. Raquel over to Malkin, backhand, scores! Bunting may have had the last touch. Pittsburgh's got the lead.
Really one of the few times the Senators have looked a bit discombobulated in their zone in this game, but Pittsburgh takes advantage of it. And again, it's a bit of a wacky bounce. The puck comes around the wall here, and avoiding the stick was Pickering, and he throws it, and it goes off the skate and goes right back to the blue line. And as this shot comes to the net, goes over to Malkin. He lays it in. I think Bunting may tip it on the way through, but again, some fortuitous bounces for the Penguins, and they take full advantage of it. Nice play down low to Malkin, and I'm not sure Bunting gets anything on that. This might go in on its own. I think Malkin's got his second goal of the period. And that overhead pretty much solidifies that.
And they come 2 minutes and 3 seconds apart.
But the pass from the blue line down to Malkin, that was the key play of that goal. That really set Malkin in a real good spot.
Coming off his 12th 25-goal-plus season, three times he's been a first-team All-Star center in the league. And Malkin with a pair of goals here to give Pittsburgh its first lead of the night.
Well, he's talked about being a better leader. I think he's been a leader by example over a lot of years. I don't think he gives himself enough credit, but the one way you become a real good leader is at key times in games, you take control of games. And right here in the second period, down 2-1, Malkin with two goals to give the Penguins the lead.
First was a power play goal at 14:59, and now at 17:02. Pittsburgh takes the lead late in the second period. See how Ottawa responds. Hamonic out there, or excuse me, Klevin trying to hold the zone, but out comes Ryan Rust with Crosby. Watched by Cousins. Crosby to the line. That pass knocked down by Amadio, who tries to get away. Grizzlick there for Pittsburgh.
A couple of weird goals on Forsberg. I mean, those are goals that the Senators are hoping to avoid.
Here's Pizzo walking in front, and Larson down, and Philip Larson, who has not been called upon yet since coming in for Tristan Jarry, holds on to that.
Well, one guy the Senators didn't have to start the season last year, and for quite a lengthy time, was Shane Pinto. And he's going to get a full training camp and an opportunity to start the season, and he brings a lot of different things to the table for the Ottawa Senators, and he's the kind of guy that will take the puck out of a corner. He will drive it to the net. Good centerman, good two-way centerman. And I think they'll be glad that he's in the lineup to start the season.
Stützle wins a faceoff. Giroux back to Shabbat. His shot deflects wide of the net. In front it goes. Giroux on the backhand, spins back, hits Shabbat, and that's up on the mask. And Larson took that flush, but able to pounce on the puck and collect himself after that.
Well, nice save by Larson, even though it hit him in the head. That's a save in my books. And great job by Claude Giroux. He didn't like the feeling of where he had the puck, so he laid it back to Shabbat. Good job by the centers. I like the way they're digging out pucks on the forecheck. And not only is he digging out, but Tkachuk finds Giroux through the seam. And then Giroux smartly lays this right in the wheelhouse of Shabbat. I think it got a bit on his front foot, so when he got it, it went straight up and caught Larson right in the mask.
Another offensive zone faceoff win by Stützle. Jensen's shot caromed in front. Bounces back to Jensen. Held it in momentarily, and now Pettersson plays it back into the center zone. 80 seconds left in the period as first Ontario's Claude Giroux red line and in. Bouncing puck. Oh, Larson had to be sharp on that. Cycled by Tkachuk behind the net. Around for Shabbat. Near side, Jensen moves up again. Stützle backs him up. Final minute of the period. Back to Stützle. Positions himself against Hayes, shooting. And he missed stick side. Jensen in deep. Threw it in front. Off the bench, Keane Sanderson finds Patterson, and that's a left pad stop by Larson. So Ottawa pushing here in the late stages of the period. Looking for an equalizer. Ridley Gregg is in. Here's Gregg handing it off. Patterson backhand. Got his own rebound. Checked by Crosby along the boards, and Sidney Crosby works it past Sanderson and out. And Minnick drops it back into the Penguin zone. Late stages of the period. Amadio upended. Crosby in. Sending it across. Malkin back out. And a sprawling play by Cousins to clear. And that will do it here in the second through two. And Evgeny Malkin with two goals in a 2-minute and 3-second span has given Pittsburgh a 3-2 lead.
Well, the two veteran stars for the Penguins have got the goals for them. One from Crosby, two from Malkin. And how about this play here? You dump it in, and if it lands on the corner of the puck, it can jump in a lot of directions. And hey, the Penguins have had a couple of good bounces. Why not the Senators as Drew dumps that in? And then coming up the ice late was Batherson on his backhand wide. Tried to go straight upstairs short side on Larson, but he was there to knock it out of harm. Nothing like it. And the players have really, really taken it to heart. And you listen to both coaching staffs and both general managers and how happy they are to have their teams here. It's just a wonderful experience.
Yeah, full marks to both organizations. Mike Sullivan earlier today talking about what a privilege it was for his group to be here. I'm glad Chris Letang reminded Rob Falls and the rest of us, for a lot of these Penguins, it is their first preseason game. They had one canceled last night because of a plane issue. Actually on the tarmac for 3 hours. Crosby unable to get that shot through, and Letang lost it. Tkachuk now after it. Gets knocked down, an interference call coming up. And an early third period power play for Ottawa.
Well, Brady Tkachuk is going off the ice holding his right shoulder.
He didn't look right, did he?
He fell awkwardly there with Letang. He was trying to get position on Letang so he could chase the loose puck down. It's good that he's standing up here now. Looks like it's coming around. A little stinger maybe, but a little bobble at the blue line, and you got Tkachuk bearing down on you. Crosby misses the one time, and he throws to Letang. He heals it, goes off the heel of the stick, and as they fight for position, the stick of Letang kind of gets hooked into Tkachuk, and he goes down, and it was an easy call for the referee to make, although I think Tkachuk was grabbing onto his left shoulder as well. That's what Letang was telling the referee he wasn't happy about.
Well, he gets checked out, hopefully. Everything's okay after watching what happened in Montreal last night with David Reinbacher early and then Patrick Laine shortly thereafter.
And injuries are a big part of training camp. I mean, you're going to have some. You got to try to avoid them as much as you can, but you're going to have some for sure. You just hope they're not serious, and you hope they're not to your, you know, your star players.
So Shabbat with the slingshot back to Giroux. On the move is Ridley Gregg. David Perron sends it around. Perron with 84 career power play goals. Second unit starting and turned away 30 seconds in. Olin and Gruden come out in a penalty kill roll for Pittsburgh. Here's Perron. Looking across, finding Giroux. Gruden breaks that up. Now in on this right side, Pinto. Trying to lower the shoulder, kicks it back to Shabbat. Olin knocked it off his stick. Pinto in the corner. Puck played by Pickering, and Pittsburgh clears.
That's a nice little shovel pass there by Pickering to Grizzlick. That gets you out of harm's way and a clean exit out of your zone. A good solid play there by Pickering. Kachuk on the ice, so I think everything is good with that shoulder.
So Kachuk comes on, Batherson. Stutzla in his own zone. He'll wind it up. Through center and now back to Sanderson. Zone entry, left side too far for Kachuk, so Sanderson continues on himself. That was picked off, and Pittsburgh clears once again.
Well, frustrating for the Ottawa Senators power play, which looks so good early on in the game, and right now they're having trouble just entering the Penguins zone. Penguins doing a great job of stymieing them, killing the play, and then 200 feet down the ice he goes.
Back in, Grizzlick along the end boards, broken up by Stutzla. Hot shot, and that was blocked by Poland. As Kachuk let it fly. Now Kachuk to the bench. Stutzla. Sanderson. Penalty done. Stutzla down low. And Grizzlick got a stick on that. Pass across for Jensen. And Letang beats him to the puck.
Well, Kachuk left the ice. He went right straight to the bench and right straight to the locker room. So obviously there's something with that shoulder that he doesn't feel is quite right. Not saying it's serious, but something that is just not jiving with him.
Yeah, even when he came out to start the shift, he still looked like he was adjusting, trying to feel comfortable. We'll watch to see if we have seen the last of Brady Kachuk this evening. There's Malkin intercepting. Malkin with a pair of second period goals that has Pittsburgh in the lead. Marcus Pettersson. Here is Runick with the shot, glove down, and a penalty is coming up.
Well, Brady Kachuk is going to come off the bench for the power play. He's still rotating that elbow or shoulder that he doesn't quite feel right. And there was a couple of times he went for the puck and handled the puck, and there was the shot he took that hit Poulin. And I think right there he's feeling like, nah, I'm not digging this here. I'm going to head off and have the trainers have a look at it. A little closer look at it anyway, and he went straight to the locker room. Sometimes those awkward falls, those ones where he's already on one knee and then he goes down, your balance is a bit off and you land on the stick or you just twist it. It doesn't take much sometimes. Better to get off and take care of it now.
Benson in the box and Pittsburgh to the power play. Have a power play goal off the stick of Malkin in the game. Malkin upends Gregg, and that power play lasted 10 seconds. Malkin to the box, and we'll play 4-on-4.
Well, we'll have a look at the Jensen penalty. You're going to see him go to pick the stick up right there, Renouf, and he catches him right in the face, and that was a high-sticking call, and he's sitting in the box, and it didn't take long, and right here, 71, trip 71, as Malkin's stick gets in the skates of Ridley Gregg, and that'll negate the power play. Only 10 seconds worth of power play for the Penguins, and we'll have a little 4-on-4 action. And the ice surface will open up a little bit.
Adio wins that faceoff cleanly against Crosby. It's Batherson at the line, or Sanderson, excuse me. Giroux up front, along with Stutzla. Here's Rust. Crosby, and he had Grizzlick going down the lane, but the pass deflects up into the seats.
Winner years of $250,000 to upgrade their arena and tonight's NHL preseason game. We celebrate Elliott Lake, Ontario, proud winner of Kraft Hockeyville 2024.
A couple of real good seasons for Jake Sanderson, and we know he's a great skater and he's going to be a real good talent. 200-foot player right there. Great stick defensive play. Crosby's coming in. Grizzlick's coming down the far side. He knows exactly where both guys are. Great stick position by Sanderson. Yeah, he deflects that out of harm's way. I mean, 230-plus point seasons for Sanderson, and just looking at him to grow into a more of a leader on this team and taking on more of a role on that back defensive court.
21:55 in his rookie year, 23:13 his average time on ice. Last year, he's going to be up over 25.
I just like to see him take the reins of that first power play. I'd like to see him get a crack at that, give him some opportunities there, and he's going to munch minutes. I mean, the guy skates effortlessly. I mean, I played against his dad. I played with his dad at the World Championships. And he always impressed me as a skater and a shooter, such a fantastic player. And Jake's got a lot of similarities in his skill sets.
Somebody was hit with a puck in the seats, and the referee wanted to make sure that the paramedics on duty here will go to work to make sure everybody's okay. Rudick turned aside here as Pinto blocked the shot. And now Shabbat starts out. Sheen Pinto, five shots in the game for Pinto. Over the line, that puck flipped towards Larson, and he will club that harmless shot down.
Well, since the first, halfway through the second period, one of the things you notice with Ottawa is they're not attacking with the speed and the transition that they were earlier in the hockey game, and that's what really put the Penguins on their heels. They were just transitioning, and their attack was ferocious. They were all over them. And they had a great first period. It's kind of slowed down for them a little bit. And they don't seem to have the same rhythm and tempo they had earlier in the hockey game.
Senators in Montreal on Tuesday. They'll be in Detroit on Thursday. And good news, Keith Tkachuk, or Brady Tkachuk, back on the bench.
Well, we've seen a lot of them over the last few months. Of course, he witnessed his brother Matthew win the Stanley Cup, and he's having a conversation with Batherson, letting him know how he's doing. But you watch your brother go through 2 years of battling for that Lord Stanley and what he went through to win it, and that's inspiring.
Here's Sanderson flipping it. That goes high. Stützle up with that. Dragged back by Letang. Now Rust the other way. Brian Rust dropping it. Crosby. And across. Here's Letang with a shot. Forsberg stopped that. Loose in front. And rolled ahead. Maybe a two-on-one if Giroux can get there. But Grizzlick beats him to the puck.
What a great play by Grizzlick. So used to seeing him in a Bruins jersey. 8 years with the Boston Bruins. He didn't change much of the colors of the uniform for sure. But the Pittsburgh Penguins are going to love Matt Grizzlick. What a player he is.
Now Shabbat swings it in. Not only 8 years of Bruins, but Dad, for how many years part of the
very
ice
familiar.
Gig? Yeah.
Very familiar with that. I was a Bruin, and I knew his father very well.
So he's left home after all these years.
Finally, get him out of there.
There's Pinto. Steams back at full strength. And in comes Pinto, whips that wide. Clevin steps up. Now Cousins follows. Around to Bernard Docker. Nick Cousins, who opened the scoring, knocked down in the Pittsburgh zone. Malkin with a pair, hands it off, and Raquel tries to flip that deep. Clevin off the boards. It came back in off bunting, a delayed offside. And Bernard Docker to the red line and in. There's Renouf. Gets past Malkin. Bunting trying to get away. Sends it across. Back, and Bunting deflecting it. Nice stop by Forsberg. Bunting from behind the net. Looked to bank that. Pickering to Malkin. Here's Raquel. Bunting in front. Renouf. Pickering. Here's Raquel. And Forsberg, a nice stop. The rebound and a good stick there by Batherson. Might have saved the rebound chance. Ostapchuk Behind the net to Hewitt, trying to give it back to Ostapchuk. And flip pass Sanderson and out. Kamenik drops it back in. Past 7 minutes of the third. Still a one-goal Pittsburgh lead. Stützle back in his own zone. A touch pass for Janik. And that shot held onto by Forsberg. And a little dust up after that. As I think it was Poulin with a shot, and he ends up getting tackled.
Well, the shot was against Timmy Stützle.
Yeah.
And I think that's what generated all the attention that came after that. Two great chances for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and then a little sloppiness in the zone for the Ottawa Senators. And they get kind of caught a little bit, and then at the end of that shift, Poulin and Stützle were going at it, and that didn't make Mr. McEwen very happy as he came in and jumped on his back and settled that. Bunting, first of all, the nice give and go right here with Pickering. Good backhand, and what a save by Forsberg there, and then turning around Raquel with the first shot, and then the rebound backhand, and a nice sliding save right there. And there's all the traffic in front, and that will draw a lot of attention when you're picking on the young superstar.
Take a look at this list of notable NHL players. Al Arbor, Toe Blake, two outstanding coaches. In fact, in the 80s, they had a special dinner honoring the pair of them for the number of Stanley Cup victories they had. Randy Carlyle, Tyler Bertuzzi, who comes up every summer, still fishes at the local lakes in the area. Mike Foligno has a place on Long Lake. His family is still and very much entrenched in what the Northern Ontario experience is all about. They do love their hockey up here, guys.
And Rob, the banners, which include your name along with Joe Bowen, you come into this rink and see all the banners, and a lot of NHL rinks don't have names that resonate through their careers quite like the ones that hang here in Sudbury. So a power play, Hamidic gets the lone penalty on the tackle. There's Pinto having his stick break. Fortunately, right in front of the bench, he goes off. Crosby scores. Sidney Crosby with his second of the game.
Well, he knows where to sit, you know, and they know where he likes to go. And he doesn't get to start the season with the guy he knows best, Getzel, but a smile on Sidney Crosby's face, and the fans will be thrilled. The kids here at the game love to see Sidney light the lamp. And a broken stick, unfortunately, by Pinto. He was trying to clear the puck. The real frustration is he had to go to the bench, and then Ridley Gregg jumps on for him, but it's just a split second and a half late, and that allows Rust to feed over to Crosby. And you mentioned, you know, Letang knowing exactly where Crosby is. Rust has been a part of this deal since 2017. He's the last of the four of them that won that cup in 2017, and he knows where Sid likes to hang out.
McEwen goes after Poulin right off the faceoff. That in response to the Stützle. Poulin doesn't look interested, but Amama now with Janik. And Amama unloading. Janik, pretty tough customer in his own right, but maybe out of his weight class here. Now Poulin getting wrestled down by McEwen as well as it heats up in Sudbury.
Well, I mentioned I did the game the other night with UCC when Pezzetta ran into Tavares, right? And I thought there was going to be a lot of action off of that, and it was fairly quiet. I was surprised. This one here with Timmy Stützle, I don't think they were going to let it go. And, you know, they're just letting, I guess, people know and teams know that that's not a guy you're going to mess with. And Poulin got the ire of McEwen and Janik. And Janik standing in there with Amama, who can really throw them. He is one tough customer. And right off the faceoff, they're trying to get a piece of Poulin. He didn't want any part of it. But unfortunately for Janik, he gets Amama, and that's a couple of rights he took there and there, but he stood in there pretty good. And Brady Tkachuk, the captain of the Senators, giving a stick tap on the boards for his teammates getting involved.
Amama with three career fights last year. Curtis McDermott, he's also fought Ryan Reeves, and his first fight was against a very popular former Ottawa Senator, Mark Borowiecki.
Well, the Sidney Crosby goal, and now four goals by the Penguins, two by Crosby, two by Malkin. And they have opened up a two-goal lead with a little over 12 minutes to go here in the third period. And Carmel's a carbon copy of Sidney's first goal. You know, the tang through the seam and Crosby driving in the net. This time he was more sitting in this position that he loves to sit in. And in that spot, normally he just opens up his blade, just opens it up and deflects it. He's so good at it. And I would imagine the Senators and the Penguins will have this evened up. I don't think there's going to be one more than another, but we'll see. Penguins didn't have a good time with the Senators last year. I think they were 0-2 and 1 against the Senators, so it's a team that they've kind of struggled against a little bit. But as Letang said, this is game one for a lot of their players in Pittsburgh, and it took them a little while to get going, but now that they've got going, they've kind of taken over the game a little bit, and that's not going to sit well with Travis Green. And he's trying to build a team that comes out, has the start they had, and continues to play a certain way throughout the whole game. And there's no doubt that you could see a bit of a slowing down a little bit of the Senators as the game went along.
Brady Tkachuk comes out. This is her shift since he went off and briefly went to the dressing room. They go back to Stutzla, Tkachuk, and Giroux. Trying to cut this Pittsburgh two-goal lead in half. Worked behind the net, and it's Pettersson up the boards. Knocked down with Groot, able to redirect it out as Stutzla gains control. Now Tkachuk. Bernard Docker at center, Giroux over on this left side for Tkachuk. He'll flip it in, looking for Stutzla. Stutzla gets away, whips that pass, Levin shoots and stick side Larson. Got a piece of that, looked like it was going off target. Approaching 9 minutes of the third. 4-2 Penguins. Oh, that came up and caught Jensen in the face and play stopped immediately.
Well, Hayes coming over to have a look, but hockey players on the ice, you think that they would just say, okay, this happens. Jensen's going to be not too happy with Hayes here. This is a puck that you don't have to do that with. You don't have to get it up head high to a guy who's standing in front of you. If you want to dump it in, there's plenty of space around the ice you can dump it in. Used to hate it when guys hit other guys in the head with the puck unnecessarily. And Jensen, who's just standing at the blue line, takes the puck high. He'll go off for repairs. As Hayes catches him up in the head area with a dump it.
Crosby back on the ice. This is his first preseason game. Same as Letang. Michael Bunting in his first. Bunting played along with Crosby last year after the Raquel deal. There were six pieces in that deal going Pittsburgh's way for Jake Gensel. Bunting had signed a three-year deal in Carolina. Thought he was going to be there for a while. Here's Sanderson stepping up with Cousins. Drops. Cousins loose. And Larson just got enough of that. What a chance for Cousins to double dip in the game. Here's Grizzly. Up ahead trying to spring Raquel. Bernard Docker off the boards. Malkin's loaded up, but Batherson's got room. Here's Batherson wiring it wide. And Shabbat unable to hold the zone. Bernard Docker will fire it back in. Senators trying to quicken the pace. Ridley Gregg on it. Oh, the official stepped on a loose puck and cartwheels down. Here's Bernard Docker. Shot slowed up. And Batherson can't get it to the net. Loose. It bounces back to Batherson. Bernard Docker again fires. And knocked down in front of the net is Perron. Here's Shabbat. Played it across the front of the Pittsburgh goal mouth, and Malkin there to take it away. Up ahead to Glass off the bench. Here comes Cody Glass cutting in on the backhand. Forsberg stops that. Glass down behind the Ottawa net. Stutzla picks it up. Shabbat backs to Stutzla. Sidesteps Glass. Tkachuk's on the move. Oh, Giroux back to Tkachuk in front. Larson the stop, and Tkachuk couldn't tuck it under him. Here's Cody Glass back in. Got it to Hayes. Weak shot, Forsberg stopped that. And the pace has picked up with under 9 minutes to go. Third period, Stützle on the move, trying to split the Penguins' blue line, but Crosby got a stick on that. Head for Rust. Back to the captain. Here comes Sidney Crosby over the line. Checked on the play by Amadio. Crosby trying to get it back. Keeps it in. Rust to the backhand. Flips it across the front of the Ottawa net. Letang at the line. Finds Beauvillier. Tied up there by Shabbat. Shane Pinto ahead for Cousins. Red line and in. Grizzly backside stepping Amadio. Letang for Raquel. Lost it, and Greg charges back in. One on four, got a quick shot away off the glove of Larson. And Raquel plays it past Bernard Docker down, not enough for icing. Breaks Ottawa with Batherson swinging past Malkin. Ahead it goes to Perron, and Craig flipped in behind the net. Batherson knocks his man down, but in turn, it took down Perron. And Malkin to the attack. Four Penguins invade. Dropped off. Raquel off the crossbar. Ricard Raquel comes close. Malkin back out at center. Probably our longest stretch without the whistle tonight.
A couple of great chances at each end. Tkachuk all by himself in front, and then Raquel off the iron.
Hayes deflecting that in. Travis Hamonic goes back. Around for Tkachuk. Cody Glass bounced along the boards by Stützle. Comes loose, and Giroux starts back. Like Hamonic wanted to jump, but now peels back and heads to the Ottawa bench on a change. Here's Hayes. Through center. Brunick with the shot, and Forsberg, not sure where it is. Play stopped. Puck was knocked into the net, but the official rules said he had halted play.
Brady Tkachuk was trying to get an inch closer for the Ottawa Senators. Wide open, he jams the brakes on, loses his footing, can't get the backhand on it. And then Malkin, nice drop to Raquel, up high off the crossbar. And this one coming to the net, deflection from Hayes. And even though they found it a bit too
career total. He has 498 career goals. But this is what he said he might do when he gets to that 500 mark for his career.
If I score 500 goals this year, I will like celebrate like this.
That's the Phil Kessel bobblehead doll. And you know what? I think I'd want to see that. He's a big man going down the ice on his belly.
He might do it.
2 goals and an assist for Malkin tonight. 7 points for the three senior members of this Pittsburgh team. Crosby with a pair of goals. Letang has 2 assists. Letang losing it. Nick Cousins on it, but Grizzlick ties him up. Pinto after it in the corner, works it loose. Back to the line, and on the backhand, Hamonic sends it deep into the Pittsburgh zone again. Knockdown was Pinto. Swung back towards Pinto, can't knock that down. And it's Grizzlick. An outlet on the tape for Rust. And away goes Beauvillier. Looking for Rust again, and it rolls through to the goalie, and Forsberg lost it. It'll come back to Owen Pickering. Looked across, trying to connect with Rust. He's heading off. Another pass towards Rust. That's 2 in a row where he didn't take the pass because he was on a line change.
Really crazy. 16 consecutive seasons you make the playoffs, and now 2 straight you don't. It's got to be a strange feeling for Malkin and Crosby and Letang and Rust and those guys. that have been to the Stanley Cup and won Stanley Cups to be sitting at home in the summer. It's got to drive them crazy.
All good here for Renouf. Well, you've talked about how they need the power play to be better. A pair of power play goals tonight. Ridley Gregg works that ahead. And now Batherson trying to get loose. Got tied up as Pickering able to recover defensively. There is Pickering up for Malkin, who was headed off. And now under 4.5 minutes remaining. Inside the line, it's Hayes. Mama back out there, first shift, I think, since his fight with Yannick, who's also back on the ice. Cousins looking for Yannick, trying to get loose down that right side. Pumped by Pettersson. And Hayes with the clear, rolling back into Ottawa territory. Stützle. Tyler Kleben. Now Giroux sends it down the ice. Philip Larson out to play that with Tkachuk bearing down. Mamama lost it, and it'll come to Stützle. Bounced over his stick. In deep, Tkachuk. And Pittsburgh up with it and will flip out to center. Stützle tried the one touch for Tkachuk, doesn't work. Shabbat, Giroux fires that in and heads off. That takes a funny bounce, and Stützle pounces on it. Quick shot, get his own rebound. Back up top, Bernard Docker, and that sailed high. Krizlik pounded by Stützle. Beauvillier helps out, and that flips over the glass. And out of play. 2:55 remaining in the third. Sidney Crosby's second of the game gives Pittsburgh. We're here early this morning. In fact, they were chanting his name a half hour before he made his way down the red carpet. And a lot of these fans not disappointed here tonight.
Well, anytime you come to see Sidney Crosby play, you want to see Sidney Crosby score goals. That's exactly what he's done. He's got a couple tonight. Yeah, you see him on the red carpet. I mentioned earlier, such a great ambassador to the game. He understands the community. He understands grassroots hockey. He loves being a part of these events, as does Mike Sullivan and the Penguins organization.
Net empty, 6-on-5. As the Senators try to close the gap here with just under 3 minutes remaining. Mike Yeo drew up a face-off play during our last break. And now Sanderson kicks it back. Stützle onto the left side for Tkachuk with his own entry. Back towards Stützle. Fired around by Malkin. And Sanderson back at his own line. Batherson can't get loose. Here's Malkin looking for the hat trick and scores. So Evgeny Malkin and Crosby have combined for all five tonight. And the hats come down here at the Sudbury Community Arena.
It's just preseason, but as a player, when you score goals in the preseason and you find that you're just on top of it and you're feeling it, it does leak right into the regular season. You go in feeling really confident. So for the Penguins to see, you know, Evgeny Malkin score three here, and hopefully he has a good preseason. That gets his confidence up high, steps right into the regular season. Hopefully he gets to 500 quickly, and that's energy he'll draw off of moving through the season. But Malkin and Crosby just fantastic in this game. Knocking it down at center ice, turning the puck over, posted in. Ottawa just really never got into the zone and got control of the puck really well. And the Penguins did a nice job starting off in this game extremely slow. But midway through the second period, they found their legs. And they have been the better team back down the stretch and of this game. And they've got themselves a three-goal lead with 2 minutes and 16 seconds left. And Malkin's got himself a hat trick.
A couple of losses to start the preseason against Buffalo. This is their third game. And en route to their first win. It's going to be a busy week. The canceled game has been rescheduled. They'll play four of the next five nights.
when you have a veteran club, like the star players are veteran players, you're not overplaying them in the preseason. You're going to keep their minutes down. This was a special game Pittsburgh wanted to be a part of. They brought the Stars out. So did the Ottawa Senators. Good on to both organizations, and they put on a pretty good show here.
It'll be the first regulation loss for Ottawa in the preseason. Again, they've got Montreal Tuesday in Detroit on Thursday, and they'll finish at home in the preseason on October 5th. Against the Montreal Canadiens. Here's a quick shot by Amadio, turned aside by Larson, who's had a clean sheet so far in this game.
He came in, made a couple of saves, big saves right away. And he's been just solid for the Penguins.
Bernard Docker tied up there by Glass. Loose for Crosby. Beauvillier coming on. Crosby up high, looking for Pettersson in front as he went to the net. The big defenseman along the boards. Glass is there. Beauvillier knocked it loose. Crosby after it. Cousins can't clear, and now it's Pinto. Up ahead, rolled through. Cousins going to turn back and head off as we head into the final minute of the third period. Elliot Lake, Sudbury have done Kraft Hockeyville proud. An icing call against Ottawa. Evgeny Malkin with the hat trick tonight.
Well, big time. I couldn't agree with you more. Yeah, Evgeny Malkin had a special night tonight here in Sudbury. He had the bounces going for him. You know it was going to be his night. That one off the stick of Jake Sanderson. And then this one here, hitting the seam, backhand, finds its way through Forsberg. That's one he had to have for the Senators. He didn't. And then right here, he makes it happen for himself. Good anticipation in the neutral zone. He stick checks the puck, takes it into the zone, waits out Sanderson, finds the hole in the ice, and buries it into the empty net for the hat trick. And they will be heading. It looks to be back on the power play for 2 minutes here. So 48 seconds.
Unique was ushered off the ice.
Well, maybe
may have taken a little chop at Crosby and got a 10-minute misconduct.
Might be a misconduct, yeah. That's what it is.
Second hat trick of the preseason for Pittsburgh. Yes, a Puljujärvi had one in a 7-3 loss against Buffalo. All three Pittsburgh goals. He's had a good camp for the Penguins. Shabbat back. Pinto looks up ice. Ridley Gregg will try and chip it past the defenseman Pickering. Final 10 seconds here. And they're going to let the clock drain. So the superstars showed up tonight. And the Pittsburgh Penguins win this Kraft Hockeyville showdown against Ottawa 5-2.
Well, just a wonderful showing here tonight. I mean, just what a great event. Congratulations again to Elliot Lake. Well deserved. Nice to see that arena getting the changes that it needs so that community can get back at it and enjoy the moments that they deserve to have. Congratulations to Sudbury here. Did a great job. This 73-year-old building hosted a wonderful event tonight. It was a pleasure to be here. And to the two teams, the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Ottawa Senators, fantastic job bringing in the heavy hitters here tonight to show this crowd a real good hockey game. And they weren't disappointed seeing their stars score some big goals. The Pittsburgh Penguins off a bit slow, but finished hard with a 5-2 win.
Shot on net for Pittsburgh, 26, and the Ottawa Senators, 38.
At this time, so Malkin, a starring role tonight with the hat trick. Crosby had 2 points, that big three combining for 8 points of the game. Senators had a couple of leads on the night on goals by Nick Cousins and Tim Stützle, but Pittsburgh scores the last four. 5-2 the final.